Hey, everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see the 42-year-old, six-time Super Bowl champion Tom Brady and the New England Patriots as they match up with Marcus Mariota and the Tennessee Titans. With that, let's get you up to Nashville and Nissan Stadium. For the call, we welcome in our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thanks. We are across the Cumberland River from downtown Nashville at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the New England Patriots. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gawden. Now, Charles, you and I, we've done a lot of games together. Always seems like we're rehashing the same storylines. Turnovers, of course, always a big story. Quarterback play, running backs, yada, yada, yada. But getting ready for this one word kept coming to mind, and that's preparation.
Well, it's critical to be prepared physically, mentally. When you think about getting ready for an NFL game, you have to wonder, what will they throw at us that maybe we haven't seen before? Two-minute drill, maybe different things like that. Got to be prepared. You're exactly right.
Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The fifth-year quarterback, Marcus Mariota, ready to lead the Titans. Mariota still looking for his first 16-game season. He did pack on a few pounds in the offseason this year. Said he hopes to add a little durability and stay healthy throughout.
Mike, move on. He can't hang. He's not going to get me.
A first down throw for Mariota. And this one caught by Delanie Walker. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
But that's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well. And he's got it.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Throwing is Mariota. He'll buy some time right. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And finally taken down at the 35-yard line. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield. Those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taken off with it. What a big-time pickup on that play.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now a first-time 1,000-yard rusher from a season ago. It's Derrick Henry, and he won't get much. Maybe a couple down inside the 35 to the 34. And we roll now on the graphics for the offensive starters.
Let's take a look at the left tackle, Taylor Lewan. A big, gregarious guy with great athletic ability. Plays the game with a little bit of an edge. In fact, he doesn't play to the whistle. He plays to the echo of the whistle.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Mariota. He's got Lewis. It's a four-yard pickup. And just like that, it's third down.
A gain of four brings up third and four.
Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. We're scoreless after one. Ready for the second quarter from Tennessee, and it's the homestanding Titans in possession. They're on the march, but facing a third down here. Open man is Taylor. He's got it. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Oh,
throw is Mariota. And that'll be incomplete.
NFL quarterbacks work so hard on their mechanics, and they do so much repetition and practice, off-season, the whole deal. They expect it to be autopilot once the game starts. That way it eliminates any type of pressure of the game, pressure of people in your face, all of that. That didn't shine through on that throw, though, did it?
No. A little bit of a dangerous pass and off target, too. Sliding out of the pocket. And avoids the contact by sliding. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3. But now it's third down.
He was able to get away earlier in the drive, but apparently all the time they put in practice finally came to the front, didn't it? They remembered their lessons and found a way to contain him when he took off on that one.
Third and goal, Mariota. And he's going to score. It's a Titans touchdown. It's a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Titans take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. They were looking to pass the ball there, but they forgot to account for the man with the football.
Yeah, I can hear people right now saying, well, why don't you have a spy in your defense, someone who will dance with him and go where he goes? Well, oftentimes, if you utilize a spy, you've taken away someone in coverage as well. And oftentimes, the spy, not as athletic as the guy he's trying to keep up with, so he gets defeated anyway.
And he turns third and goal into a touchdown. Extra point put through by Succop, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Patriots come out led by the 4-time Super Bowl MVP and owner of a record 6 Super Bowl rings. Arguably the greatest to ever play the game, Tom Brady. And we keep asking the same questions every year. How much longer can he keep doing this? Is this the year the dynasty crumbles? And every year, Brady comes out and leads his team to the Super Bowl. They've been there now 3 years in a row, and only one team has made it 4. That's the Buffalo Bills. But remember, they lost all 4 in the early 90s. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. First down is Brady. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a 2nd and 10. Throwing now is Brady, and he's got Edelman on the out route. That's complete, and he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. And finding Edelman underneath, that's a recipe for success.
Typical route for a good slot receiver, and Edelman's one of the best in the game. Knows how to go inside with one of my college coaches used to call the Briar Patch. Got to go in there where it's tough and make those tough catches. And not only can he do it, he can often run away from people after the catch.
Let's go. Now the Patriots will use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number 1. First down. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there of 22.
He's come a long way since his time at Georgia Tech. What did he run at Tech? He ran hitches and go routes, essentially.
Yeah.
I mean, but he ran them really well. He averaged well over 20 yards a catch while he was there. And he still creates downfield in the NFL. That big body and that willingness to go catch the football. He's pretty impressive.
And his friends call him Bebe, the nickname his uncle gave him back in the day. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Brady's got his guys first and 10, and he's 5 for 6 now throwing the ball on this drive. Here's Brady to throw. That's caught. It's Thomas. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. Again, they'll throw with Brady. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Benjamin Watson in the final seconds of the first half. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up.
I don't think it's any state secret to know what they were saying before the start of this drive. Let's go and punch one in the end zone and go into the halftime feeling a heck of a lot better about ourselves. Let's go get this done.
Yeah, tie things up, and then you get a brand-new ball game. Now Steven Goskowski on for the extra point. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Likely time for one final snap as they start out 1st and 10. And we will likely not see another play here as they take the knee and head into the intermission all tied. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we send you down, an abbreviated halftime show as we get rolling to quarter three.
We thought this one would be a close battle coming in, and we have not been disappointed. But they are all even to this point. So to see if either side can pull away, let's get you right back out to Brandon and Charles for the start of the 2nd half.
Set and ready to go for the 2nd half. 1 touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. This will be taken in at the 1. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So back onto the field come the Pats for their 2nd drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it 1st and 10. So Brady and the Pats take over 1st and 10, right at the 30. Shotgun now for Brady. Catch here, left side, Thomas. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
Many teams, as soon as they spot man defense, if they haven't called a hitch, they'll get to it as fast as they can. They want to put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle on the outside and go for big yardage.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Now Brady. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. He was looking for Edelman there, and it's third and five. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
And he will have a man, Demaryius Thomas. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
I used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
Watch the screen. Pass. Shadow.
On second and nine, Brady. Thomas has got it. Complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 16 yards, a first down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had to read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four. 4 yards on the dump off at second down. Gosh, given the time and the short game, would he have been better off just dropping that?
Yeah, when you look at the clock, you think so. But it's hard to get a receiver to drop a football. They're trained to catch everything.
Brady gives to Michelle, and that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. It's a loss of two, now third down.
So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right. You look at the numbers, neither side looks on track in the ground game. Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and eight. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. A big spot now for Steven Goskowski. This for the lead in the final stages. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. You talk about a big kick under pressure in the fourth quarter. I mean, that wasn't like a 33-yarder. That was long distance.
Not only does it show the faith that they have in him, but also remember, if they'd missed that one, they're giving up the ball near midfield, so they had to be very confident that he was going to put that one through the post.
Goskowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. This fielded at the two. And he'll take this one near the 25. Call it the 26-yard line. So now Mariota and the Titans. Down 10-7. 55 seconds remaining. Back to throw. And an alley to run. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
How many times have we seen this late in the fourth quarter? Because you know the pass rush is getting after him, and they get upfield, get that great push, and what do they create? Space, and he takes off.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Mariota on the delay to Henry. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. Running back complete, and he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 11 yards there, first down. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. First carry for Deion Lewis, who won a Super Bowl with the Patriots.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5 yard or a 15 yard inadvertent or not. Now it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
And with inside of 10 seconds, 8 to be precise, we get whistles and a timeout on the field. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. This to potentially send us to overtime. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So a money kick there in the final seconds, and now, barring any hijinks on the kickoff here, partner, I think you and I, we're going to settle in for a little overtime.
And I wouldn't have it any other way. This has been a dogfight all through regulation. No reason to think it won't continue in the extra period.
Level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. This fielded at the 2. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Cover.
Now a first down carry. It's Michelle. And he'll be taken down here, and that is how this one is going to come to an end. And we've got free football, 4 quarters done, and we're dead even. We'll have overtime after this timeout. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined, but sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it, when you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack.
Boom! That's how we do it, baby!
These strong safeties, some people may not realize it. It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in him on that play emerged.
Here's Brett Kern now, on for a very important punt here in overtime. Oh, they come after him, and it's blocked. It's picked up. Remember, the ball is live. And he will score. Touchdown, Patriots. Still catching our breaths from that electric finish. You get into overtime, that's one thing. It was a great four quarters. But then an OT, not only to win it, but to win it on a defensive score. Wow.
Oh, definitely. And I think from now on, we're going to definitely travel someone who can help us, because I thought I was going to pass out at the end.